There are so many things we don't know about dinosaurs. Like, we don't know what they sounded like, we don't know why some of them had plates down their backs, and we know almost nothing about how dinosaurs mated. But despite all of this uncertainty, there is one strange thing we do know about them with surprising confidence: their body temperatures.
Hi, I'm Arkady. Cameron forgot to do the "Hi, I'm Cameron from MinuteEarth," so I'm doing it for him. Let's go!
It is weird that we can measure dinosaurs' body temperatures. I mean, dinosaurs are all dead. Plus, even if they were alive, where would you stick the thermometer? But we know with good confidence that this giant titanosaur had a body temperature of 38 degrees Celsius. Other dinosaurs had different temperatures. For example, this oviraptor was a much cooler 32 degrees, and the duck-billed myosaur had a toasty body temperature around 44 degrees. Most dinosaurs we know of had body temperatures between 36 and 38 degrees, which means that they were warmer than crocodiles and, for the most part, cooler than modern birds. For a long time, scientists debated whether dinosaurs maintained warm body temperatures by generating heat internally, which is called endothermy, or if they kept warm by absorbing heat from their surroundings, also known as ectothermy. These strategies are often called being warm-blooded or cold-blooded, though we've already made a video about the problems with those terms. But whatever you call it, scientists have finally figured out how to infer dinosaur body temperatures in order to settle the debate. And here's how they do it. Scientists can measure those temperatures thanks to a tough crystal-like mineral that accumulates in bones and teeth, known as bioapatite. Bioapatite contains mostly carbon and oxygen, but not all of those carbon and oxygen atoms are the same. Heavy isotopes, specifically C13 and O18, have a stronger attraction to each other than they do to the more common, lighter isotopes of carbon and oxygen. So when these atoms come together to form minerals, they don't stick together randomly. Instead, these heavy isotopes are more likely to end up bonded to each other than they otherwise would be by random chance. But if we crank up the heat, the heavy isotopes have less of a chance to bond with each other. So bones that form at warmer temperatures contain fewer bonds between heavy carbon and heavy oxygen than bones formed at cooler temperatures. Let me say that again. The fraction of bonded together heavy isotopes in a sample of bone can serve as a record of how warm or cool the bone was when it formed. It's not sticking a thermometer under a dinosaur's tongue, but it might be the next best thing. Analyzing the isotope ratios of modern animals like birds and crocodiles allows scientists to calibrate their thermometers and pinpoint specific dinosaur body temperatures from their isotope data. And that's how we know that T-Rex had a body temperature of 38 degrees Celsius. The body temperature data that scientists have gathered suggests that most dinosaurs were likely warmer than their surrounding environments, like T-Rex, which likely used heat generated internally to keep a body temperature about 15 degrees higher than the average air temperatures for its time. However, many likely used a different strategy. They could maintain their body temperatures by a combination of internally generated heat and heat from their environments, and in some cases, they could even adjust their body temperatures. Some dinosaurs seem to have taken this to an extreme. For example, this bird-like dinosaur called Troodon had a blisteringly high body temperature of 42 degrees, but possibly, when food was scarce, could lower its body temperature to as low as 29 degrees. Scientists learned about Troodon's fluctuating body temperature not by analyzing bones, because Troodon bones are incredibly rare. Instead, we were able to learn this ridiculous level of detail about Troodon's temperature entirely from analyzing fossilized eggshells, which contain the same temperature-sensitive materials found in bone. We don't know much about Troodon, so it's impressive that we can measure its body temperature and even detect fluctuations in that body temperature. Keep up the hot streak, paleontology. If you've watched our videos before, you've probably heard us rave about Tab for a Cause, a simple browser extension that lets you raise money for charity simply by opening browser tabs. Right now, Tab for a Cause is working with Vote America to make sure every eligible American has their voice heard in our democracy. Simply download Tab for a Cause at the link in the description, and every tab you open will help get out the vote in the upcoming election.